Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about our friend Antoine Fats, which was his nickname, Domino. So let's get started. So our friend Antoine Dominique Domingo Domino Jr. was born February 26, 1928 and raised in New Orleans, Louisiana. He's the youngest of 8 children. The Domino family was of French Creole background, and Louisiana Creole was his first language. His dad was a musician that played the violin and worked for a racetrack. Antoine learned to play the piano at age 7 from his brother-in-law, or his sister's husband, a jazz guitarist named Harrison Barrett. By age 10, Antoine was performing around New Orleans. He dropped out of high school to pursue his musical dreams. In 1946, a guy named Billy Diamond, who was a New Orleans band leader and bass player, asked our friend Fats Domino to join his band, the Solid Senders, to perform at the Hideaway Club in New Orleans. He would earn a whopping $3 a week to play the piano. That doesn't sound like very much, but back then in the 1940s, $3 went way farther than it does today, and it actually had a lot more value. So just a quick little side note there. Our friend Billy Diamond was the one that gave our friend Antoine the nickname Fats. In a quote from him, he says, "I knew Fats from hanging out at the grocery store. He reminds me of Fats Waller and Fats Pichon." Those are musicians. Those guys were big names, and Antoine, that's what everybody called him then, had just got married and gained weight. I started calling him Fats, and it stuck. Kind of silly. Not very nice, but I don't think he minded. He kind of joked about it. This lovely photo is of our friend Antoine Fats Domino and his entire family, minus 2 kids. They didn't have all of them in there yet, but I'm going to name them all anyway in a second. So our friend Fats Domino married his high school sweetheart, Rosemary Domino, pictured in the very far left, holding that beautiful little baby, in August of 1947. They were married for 60 years and had 8 children together. They named all of their children with the letter A. So they named them Antoine III, Anatole, Andre, Antonio, Antoinette, Andrea, Enola, and Adonica. It's a lot of A names. Kind of silly, but hey. Alrighty, now, even after his success, he continued to live in his old neighborhood until after a big old storm named Hurricane Katrina happened in 2005 and forced them to move to a different area or suburb of New Orleans. So today we're going to learn about a song called The Fat Man. Now this picture here to the right is the album cover of the recording or record. The Fat Man was the B-side of Detroit City Blues. Now, whenever you hear A-side or B-side, that just means it's one side or the other of the record. So side A is the main side you'd listen to first, and then the B-side of the record you'd have to flip over to play and listen to. Records are much different from CDs, and CDs are much different from what we know today, which is everything's just online. Anyway, it was written and recorded by our friend Fats Domino the same day, which was December 10th of 1949 at J&M Studio. He wrote this song with his bandleader and regular musical partner, Dave Bartholomew. And it's partly about our friend Antoine explaining the nickname Fats. So the first 2 lines of the song go like this. "They call me the fat man because I weigh 200 pounds. Sounds kind of silly, but the song stuck and it was pretty popular. So this song is often considered to be one of the first rock and roll records. It was released in 1950, titled The Fat Man, which sold well, reaching number 6 on the R&B chart and launched what was to become a great career for our friend Fats Domino. So this piece is pretty upbeat. You're going to get to watch a live performance of this. I hope you enjoy, and here we go. Thank you.
Johnny Brown, he loved me, but I know my way around. I was sitting on the corner, one rampart in Canal. I was watching old little girl.
Lots of fun. If you weren't bouncing in your seat while listening to this, I don't know what will make you bounce. This song's kind of upbeat and fun. I like listening to it. So I hope you enjoyed listening to it with me. Our friend Fats Domino was on the piano, in case you didn't know. He's really good at the piano. And again, I hope you enjoyed listening, and I will see you next time.